everyone, you are watching series of success stories brought to you by Indian Achievers Forum. I am Anshita and today's success story is about Miss Rajasi. She is the CEO of Zeda Impex.
Indian Achievers Forum is driven by a full-fledged advisory board. The board consists of experienced personalities who have excelled in their respective careers. Together, the forum organizes conferences, events, workshops, exhibitions, trade shows, and B2B initiatives in India as well as abroad. Where there is passion, there is achievement. And where there is achievement, there is Indian Achievers Forum.
How are you?
Very good, Anshita. How are you doing?
I'm doing really well too. Thank you. So, Rajasi, could you please tell us a little bit about yourself and also about your professional roles and responsibilities?
Okay, so I belong to Pune itself. I have been working for the last 16 and a half years now. And I started, I've always worked with the WNS, India Bulls, and TSYs and all these big giants. So I've been blessed with that. And currently I'm working with Zeda Impex as the CEO, which is an import-export trading firm. So that's about it.
Okay, amazing. So Rajasi, if we ask you, you know, how has the journey been so far? Has it been a smooth ride or were there any challenges that you had to come across? Could you tell us a bit about that?
Yeah, sure. I think the journey for me has started at a senior customer associate, and then I have eventually moved on to become a CEO. So the journey has been long, but I would call it beautiful. There have been always ups and downs. You make mistakes, you learn, but that learning has got me where I am today. So I would say that that journey has been because of that journey I'm here. So I think just the hard work I think has paid off really well for me. And that's what I keep believing in, that keep going ahead in life. And it doesn't matter, what kind of problems are coming or hindrances are coming. It's just we need to think about how to overcome it and keep moving ahead.
Wonderful. I think that's one really good piece of advice that everyone should follow. Also, Rajasi, if we talk about the future of Zeda Impex, what does that look like? Could you tell us a bit about your future plans as well?
So with Zeda Impex, yes, we are growing extremely good. We are also trying to cater into different categories like FMCG products, agricultural products. And there is a Make in India movement that has started, which is, you know, with the Atmanirbhar. And there's a lot of scope for export and import also. So we are really looking forward to go ahead in this journey and probably make India proud, because we are a very proud Indian company. So we would love to take India to the international business level.
Lovely. And I wish you all the luck for all your future endeavors as well, Rajasi.
Thank you so much.
Also, you know, could you tell us a bit about your products or services in detail, you know? What exactly do you guys work for and, you know, the entire process?
Sure. So, see, basically, Zeda Impex, Impex means trading, import-export, of course. So, what we deal into, what we do is we are working as a middle person. So, there is a manufacturer and there is a buyer. So, there is a demand and there is a supply. So, we become the middle person who is actually trying to connect these two dots. And that's not only happening at the domestic level, that's also happening at the international level. So, any person, any international entity that wants to enter into Indian market with their products like FMCG products or agricultural products, or could be medical equipments or surgical equipments, or maybe, you know, metal or furniture products, they can get in touch with us, and we take the entire business and we set up their business here in terms of finding the distributors, the wholesalers for them, and work for them as a larger partner. So that is what basically Zeda Impex we do. And as I said, FMCG, so fast moving products, anything starting from coffee to, I mean, you know, tea or maybe toothbrush, toothpaste, whatever comes in the FMCG sector, we want to deal with that, and we do deal with that also. Agricultural products, you have grains and rice and sugar and vegetables and fruits, which are of course certified, and we also have all those import export whatever requirements are done, so we make sure that we fulfill that and we trade into that. Metal and metal products, of course, I mean, the import export happens through it used to happen through China, Shanghai, but of course the main clients have been South Africa and New Zealand, UAE market also, so that is there. So yeah, I mean, that's basically what we do.
Right, amazing. So, you know, there's also one question that I'm very, very intrigued to know, Rajasi, and that is, how did you feel on winning the Indian Achievers Awards? What was the feeling and the reaction like? Could you tell us a bit about that?
Oh, that came to me, to be very honest, I was extremely surprised and overwhelmed by the response. I mean, it was mentioned to me that, you know, why don't I nominate myself? Because I think they found that my profile through LinkedIn to be right. eligible for that. So I was very overwhelmed and very excited, and I wasn't sure if I'm going to get it or not get it. But I think it's an extremely booster for me to keep moving, keep working hard, and maybe, you know, grow bigger and get my company also at a bigger platform. So I'm right. very, very, very happy. Really, thank you so much for the entire
I think you are truly well-deserved, Rajasi. You were doing some great work with your company, and, you know, we are all very, very proud of you.
Thanks.
So, before we actually conclude today's session, Rajasi, any last message or piece of advice that you would like to give to everyone who's watching you right now? Any message that you would want to give?
The only thing that I think, if you have an idea, just stand by it. And if you believe in something, just keep doing it and don't get bogged down by the difficulties that you may that may arise in achieving towards your goal. I think those difficulties are actually taking you to the right path, because unless and until you try something and you fail once, you don't get to get up again and go ahead. So I think just keep moving, keep working hard, and always have the positive thought process, and that's about it. I think then there is no looking back.
Right, I think that's very well put. So thank you for being with us today, Rajasi. You are truly an achiever, and I wish you all the luck for all your future projects as well. May you keep inspiring us all like you have been all this while with your new milestones.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you. Pleasure is ours. Thank you. Yeah.